Hello guys, so let us continue the video. So now the leftover part is which we are going to cover is the stowage, and the second thing is the segregation. Stowage and segregation we are going to cover, and after that we will be covering the supplement. So let us see what is stowage. So as you can see in the dangerous goods list, so in the previous videos we had covered till this portable tanks and bulk containers. So the leftover part was EMS and stowage and segregation and the properties, etc. So let us see what is stowage and handling. So there are two things, one is stowage and one is handling in this column. It is column 16A and the segregation column is 16B. So let us go to stowage and handling. So as we can see, this column 16A. So now they have divided this stowage in three ways. So as you can see in this column, there is two things, stowage and handling. So here it is stowage code and here it is handling code. So this both codes are there. Other than this, there is stowage category. So these three things are there. So now let us see what is stowage category. So stowage category for class 1, it is like from 01 to 05, and for class 2 to 9 it is A to E, and this A to E means A, B, E are which are under deck and deck and under deck, and for C, D they are only on the deck. So let us see in the supplement, in the dangerous or in the IMDG code, what is this stowage category. So stowage category, let us go to the IMDG code. So here you can see, let us see the stowage category. Stowage category is basically in here you can see part 7. This is volume 1 part 7. So here you can see, so let us go to page. So here it is, stowage and provisions. So here you can see this, therefore stowage categories for class 1, category 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So for category 1 they have divided into cargo ships and then passenger ships. So for both this they have given us that what we can load on deck, enclosed cargo transport unit or under deck. So for stowage category 1 cargoes, if we are loading this in cargo ships, then we can load in a closed cargo transport unit or on deck and under deck both. Like that we have to see. So there are five categories, stowage category 01 to 05, that is for class 1, and for stowage categories for classes 2 to 9 are nothing but A, B, C, D, E. And as we have seen here that for class 2 to 9 it is A to E. So A, B, E are for deck and for under deck, while C and D are only for on deck. So let us see here, A, B, so these are on deck or under deck, on deck, under deck, and for B also it is on deck or under deck, but for C it is only on deck, and D only on deck, and E is on deck or under deck. So that is why I have written here that A, B, E is deck and under deck, and C, D is only deck. So this is the stowage category. Then other than this, we have stowage codes. So there are 29 codes, right from SW1 to SW29. And there is handling codes, that is there are 4 codes, H1 to H4. So let us see further. So here you can see, these are the stowage codes. So for SW1 it is telling us protected from sources of heat. For SW2 it is telling keep clear of the living quarters, like that. This is the storage code till 29. Then we have handling code. So if H1 is written, then you have to take this into consideration. Keep as dry as reasonably practicable. So let us see for example from the dangerous goods list. Now storage and handling, here you see it is written category E or category B. So as I have already shown you that this is category A to E, so one of this category it's written. And from seeing here the category, we can identify where we have to store this cargo. And in some places you will see the storage code, like for example here SW2. So SW2 is a storage code. And handling code, in some places you will see like H1 or H2, like that. Otherwise it will tell you the category and the storage code. So all those precautions you have to take for storage and handling. Mostly it will be taken, but otherwise you have to take for understanding purpose. This is how it is. So this was all about our storage. Now let us see regarding segregation. So in segregation there are first thing is the segregation table. The other thing is segregation table for various ships. Here various ships like general cargo ship, ro-ro ship, container ship, lash barge, etc. So there are segregation table for various ships. Then there is one thing called as segregation codes. So there are 75 codes, right from SG1 to SG75. And other than segregation code, there is segregation groups, that is 1 to 18 groups. And this groups, they are actually based on the similar chemical properties. So that is why they are grouped into 1 to 18. And so let us see what is segregation. So we have already seen the storage, now storage and handling. Now let us see the segregation. Now here it is the definition it is given, that segregation is the process of separating two or more substances or articles which are considered mutually incompatible. So when two or more substances are mutually incompatible, so they together may result into undue hazards in case of leakage. So if there is any leakage, there will be undue hazard or any accident. So because of this mutually incompatible cargoes, there is a need of segregation. So this segregation are carried out from these four terms, that is away from, separated from, separated by complete compartment or hold, and separated longitudinally by an intervening complete compartment or hold. So here it is given segregation provision. So to determine the segregation requirements between two or more dangerous goods, the segregation provisions, including the segregation table and column 16B of dangerous goods list, shall be consulted. It says that to determine segregation requirement between two or more dangerous goods. So to determine the segregation, you can see the segregation table, or you can see the column 16B of dangerous goods list. So dangerous goods list is here. This is the column 16B. So here you can see SG50, SG57. So this is how it will be. Mud captains, liquid flammable. So for this, SG50 and SG57 is written. So this is how you will determine. And to see the description of SG50 and SG57, let me take you to the segregation here. So first is the segregation table, and after this, these are segregation groups which I have shown you. This segregation groups which are 1 to 18. So this is 1 to 18. These are segregation groups which refer to dangerous goods list, and they are having certain chemical properties. Because of this, they are segregated in this 18 groups. Let us go to the segregation code. These are segregation codes SG1 Then SG2, here it is written segregation as for class 1.2G, etc. Then for SG20, if it is written SG20, then you have to stow away from acids like this. So this is how you can read the segregation code. So segregation code, we have, as I said, 75 codes, and segregation group is 1 to 18 based on similar chemical properties. Now let us see what is segregation table. So segregation table was above. So this is the segregation table 7.2.4. So in this, how you have to read this? Now there are, there is asterisk marks, there is cross, then there are numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. So let us see what this tell. If it is written 1, it is separated away from, then 2 separated from, 3 and 4, and then X means the dangerous goods list has to be consulted to verify whether there are any specific segregation provisions. So X means you have to consult dangerous goods list, and asterisk means see 7.2.7.1 of this chapter for segregation provision between class 1 substances or articles. So if you see this segregation table, here you can see that here there are stars or asterisks for only for class 1. See, this is 1 and this is 1, and here also class 1. So only for this the asterisks are there, otherwise in the whole segregation table there is no asterisk. So it is only for class 1. So as the star says, that see 7.2.1 of this chapter for segregation provision between class 1 substances. So if you want to keep any explosives along with the other explosives, then it says to go to 7.2.7.1. So let us go to 7.2.7.1. So here it is, segregation of goods of class 1. So if you are keeping two class 1 goods together, so this is what you have to refer. So here it is written like compatibility group, and this is cross. So cross means here it is written, it indicates that goods of the corresponding compatibility groups may be stored in the same compartment hold or closed cargo transport unit. So if it is cross like X, then they may be stored together in one compartment. Now let us see what is this X1, X6 means. So for seeing this, here you can see, you can read 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So after reading that, you can easily identify that how you have to keep that cargo, how you have to segregate the cargo from one another. So let us go back to the segregation table. So here is the segregation table. So let's say if I want to load this flammable gases along with let's say explosives, that is class 1. So here it is written 4. So if I want to load those two, then I have to use this segregation method. So this is how you have to refer this segregation table. So now let us see what are this away from, separated from, etc.